Welcome in this video, a new video today about the new product we have released, TMS FNC push notifications. Everything about using push notifications in combination with web client applications. So in a nutshell, allow you to, from the backend, send push notifications to web applications. So we'll explain in this video how web push is working. I will show you also the Delphi application that we created that uses the FNC push notifications components to send push notifications to a TMS WebCore web client application in this demo, but know that you can also use that in any other web applications created with other web technology. That's no problem. You can still use our backend tools to send these push notifications. And I will also show you what these push notifications can do when this is being used from a TMS WebCore PWA application and how it will actually show also by push notifications the badges on your mobile device where this PWA is installed. On the screen, you are seeing examples of how the push notification looks like on an Android device, the above one, and then also on an iOS device and also on a desktop browser. To give you, first of all, a brief overview of how web push notifications work, everything starts from the web application where you will first need to register to receive these push notifications. So, of course, the web application kinds of need to authorize and allow that push notifications can be received. And it is doing that by subscribing, registering with the push service. The push service that depends on the browser from where this web application is running. This registration subscription is stored with the push service and communicated to an application server. The application server, the push application server, is what you can build with a Delphi application. So you receive this information, and at the moment that you have the push subscription received by your Delphi application server, at that moment you can start sending push notifications. And that is something that you are doing with from the application server, perform a request to the push service, the service behind the browser, and it is this browser that will ultimately be responsible for sending the actual push notification to the web application running in the browser, but also meanwhile it's perfectly possible to send it to the service worker associated with that web client application. And it is the service worker that can be responsible for showing an alert, a push notification message, even when your web application is not opened, is not active. And it can also indicate as a badge that a new message was received, inviting the user to open up this PWA and inspect what kind of new information that was received. Enough theory, it's time to dive in our Delphi IDE, where I will show you all these things in action. And to show you these concepts, first of all, we have a project group with two applications. It is the push server application that you also built as a Delphi application, and a web client application. Here in this case, we have implemented it through TMS WebCore. These two example applications are included in the FNC push notifications product, so you can play with that easily yourself. Let's first have a look at the web push server application. It is a visual application, but of course, it does not need to be a visual application. If you somehow want to build this as a backend, you can build this as a console service application. That is also possible. Here you can see the information that we captured that is sent as a push notification. And you can see that we sent a push notification title and a body to the message. And optionally, we can also send a URL. The URL will be used in the device when the push notification is received to open up when you click that push notification alert. We have three components here, three components that are part of TMS FNC push notifications. Central components is the push sender component. And this is the component that actually uses the subscription object information, that unique subscription ID along with your unique user ID. It uses that information to send it to a specific URL, a URL that is specified by the push server from the browser, from where that user is using your web application. There is also the web push DB, and that is the component that manages storing the user ID together with the subscription object. So this information, of course, is at all times necessary that you want to send a push notification, and so it is managed in a database. When you have not connected your own database, it will use by itself automatically a client data set, so it will store it in an XML file, but you can equally also connect it to any database of choice that you want to use for that purpose. And there is the web push server. The web push server part is the part that is responsible for capturing the subscription object along with the user ID. So remember that when from the web application you want to register for receiving push notifications, that you get from the browser push server the unique subscription object. And of course, that object is what you will want to store locally with your push server. And so the push server is the server through which you send from the web client application this information to your backend. Let's now have a look at the web client application. So this is a web core application. And the only thing here that we do is capture a unique user ID. And here we have buttons from where you can subscribe to the push notification server and perform an unsubscribe. And that is something that is done via this web core component. It's included by default in web core, that is the web push notification component. So time to run this demo. So here we have the desktop client for the sending the push notification. So I start the push server. It is ready to receive any possible new subscriptions. And now I run my web core web client application. Let's put these two along each other. And I will first of all register with some specific user ID. So let's use Bruno and let's subscribe for push notifications. What happened in the background is that with the browser push server, a subscription was created. And when that subscription information, subscription object was received by the web client, the web core application, it was using our push server component to send this subscription information, as you can see here in the log, to send that to that push server application. And so with that, the registration is complete. And I could now, for example, send a push notification to the browser. And as you can see here, it displays as an alert in my Windows environment. Similar thing would happen when you use it from a macOS application or a mobile device, either Android or iOS. If I include the URL, send to all, a new message is received. When I click this message, you can see that this was the page that was specified here in this URL. It's actually the page where you can find our push notifications product. And so with that, you can see how simple it is to use push notifications. As an extra step, I want to show you right now how you can actually also see that in action from a mobile device using a PWA application. So remember, a PWA application is an application that sits on your home screen. So you can see how you can install that on the home screen and simply open it up from an icon on the desktop. Okay, and so here I can actually do the same thing. I'm actually already subscribed with push demo as the user ID with a push server created with Delphi with TMS FNC push notifications. Here in this case, this server is running not locally but on another server. It is behind HTTPS, so that's why I need to move to another machine to trigger from there to send a push notification. But to make it clear, I will first of all close it up, and here we have our home screen. Now I will, from this server, send a push notification, and this has been sent now. Let's try again. And okay, some delay because my Android tablet has a weaker Wi-Fi signal here, but with some delay, you can see that on the batch, two push notifications were received. When I open up this center here in the Android device, you can see that two messages have been received. If I leave this open and change here the text of my message, you cannot see that because I'm using it on a server. And let's add some text, send another notification. You can see that this is what I typed here live and sent to that device. And you can also see that at this moment the batch indicates that three push notifications have been received. It is only when I remove the push notifications from this central place that the batch with the number of received push notifications is cleared. But the most important part of this demonstration is that even when your web client application is not open, is not running, it is just sitting on your home screen, just as if it would be a native application, it is still possible to receive push notifications from your own push server. And with that, we have the circle around that allow you to build both web client applications yourself with Delphi, and also the push notification server part, also with Delphi, of course, in a cross-platform way. That's also important to specify. We use everything from Windows here, but you can create that web push server as well to run on a Mac or a Linux device. Everything is supported as we are used to and expect from our favorite Delphi tool, of course. Enjoy a new world of push notifications that opens for your web client applications. As I explained, you can use it directly out of the box with TMS Web Core. But if you build web applications with other technologies such as React or Angular or anything else, you can also use Delphi to create push notification messages for these web clients. Enjoy using this brand new TMS FNC push notifications product from TMS. For more information, don't forget to subscribe under this video here. And of course, I also invite you to like this video. Thank you very much.